Hello there, I'm Josh Medofeld-Pavel, and today we're having an interesting guest. This is the IMR, or IMR in Romanian, R2 Aten. This is an interesting EM because it is highly configurable. So this is like one of those IMs where you purchase one and you get a multitude of sounds out of just one. So this is the package. It comes with two booklets, and this is the package itself. I think that the light doesn't really do justice. They have much better colors. I actually see the video in the monitor, so I think that it really doesn't do justice to them. So they come with two cables, one which is terminated in this is a single-ended 3.5mm jack, and they also come with a cable, so it is included in the package, in their price, with a cable that is terminated in 2.5 balanced cable. Two cables in one package for the R2 Aten. They come with a multitude of tips, which will come in handy for some. Now, I have to get the little EMs out of their foam cutout. They are very securely fit in there, that is clear. So you do not have to worry that you will that they will break during transportation, and that is a positive thing. On the other hand, they are a little hard to get out of there. So they come with two of those. Those are configurability options. I will explain in just a second what each does. I have a slightly hard time getting them out of the shape. So those are the EMs, the EM capsules. This is how they look in person. I should just plug them in with the single-ended cable. So I usually review things based on single-ended because I have more single-ended than I have balanced. So reviewing things in single-ended when possible keeps everything fair for every single product, you know? Like, as a reviewer, I'm supposed to stay neutral, and using balanced for some may advantage them and may make the fight unfair compared to other products, which are single-ended. Anyways, this is how they look with the cable. Those are oxygen-free copper cables, high-quality cables. The cables are not microphonic. There are no such issues with those. I mean, they have no issues. Just look at how beautiful they are. I really enjoy their aesthetics. I think that I think that Imur and Mr. Bob from Imur have been improving a lot over the years. Like, they've been doing a lot of improvements. Compared to the original R1 I received and reviewed a few years ago, I think that this is like a very good EM. The original one was a bit harsh around the edges, to put it like that. So this is how they look while you wear them. This is how they sit in your ear. They are very comfortable, no hard edges, nothing that cuts into my ear. I am happy to report that I am having great comfort with the R2 Aten. What else can I tell you about them? Let's see. The build quality is excellent, the comfort is pretty much excellent. The sound, that is the single part that remains. They are easy to drive. They appreciate a good source though. For example, they appreciate, you can hear the differences between an iBass or two DX220 compared to other players that are cheaper, like the Shanling M2X and such. Anyways, those sound, those are a bit warm in the bass. They have a strong bass. They also have a strong sub bass. They have a pretty open and sparkly treble, at least with the original filters installed. And this is why my review on sound won't make much sense, and you'll probably have to wait until my written review to get a better idea of how they sound. So this is the thing. After you remove the tips, you are left with this. And this has two parts which are removable. And that is kinda interesting. So basically you can remove this and you reveal the inside of the EM, the driver. But the bore which you just unscrew has two parts that are removable. Basically you have both the main shaft and the tip which has the little grill. Both of those are removable and configurable and come in colors, and there are a lot of them. There is a lot to configure, and I have a lot to play with the R2 Aten. I really love the sound in this original configuration, black with black. I remember not liking this sound as much with the other IMR EMs, I remember that with the Air One Zenith, I didn't like the black-black combination or the black filters, but with those one, I really enjoy the black filters as well. I think they are great. I think they did a good job with the default settings. Like, if I was to receive those ones and just to have only this default setting and nothing else, I would probably be happy and enjoy them because I really like them. They sound really good. They sound sparkly. They sound airy. They have excellent instrument separation. They have dynamics. They don't hiss. It is a dream EM in this price range. I mean, I can't find anything to complain about. I usually search for things to complain. The comfort is good. The price is good. Everything is good about the Air 2 Aten. Like, yeah. Anyways, my videos are not meant to be full in-depth reviews. They are meant to be fun presentation of products. I thank you for watching. I hope you'll consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Also, check out my site, audiofileheaven.com, for the full in-depth review. I thank you for watching. I hope you have a lovely weekend there, and I hope to see you soon. Bye bye.